Anyhow, guys, I came to Washington to pass my own Clean Air Act, the Urkel Air Act. Most people think it's very difficult to get a bill passed, but I'm here to show you that it's as easy as growing mold. Okay, let's go right to the numero uno, the head honcho, the biggest guy of all. Mr. President.
Hello.
Wow. My name is Steven Q. Urkel, and I was wondering if you can endorse my Urkel Air Bill. It will definitely provide a clean and safe environment.
Don't you think I ought to read it first?
Well, that might be a good idea. Oh, would you like a copy?
I would like a copy of it.
Well, I'll make sure I get it over to you. Congress,
this is the place to start.
Okay.
In the Congress first, then I get to sign it.
Okay. Well, you can sign it right now. We can just bypass all that.
The Constitution gets in the way.
Oh, yeah, you're right. I shouldn't have...
You sent me the bill.
You're right. I'll send you the bill.
Right.
Wow, the president. Wow, I'm a shoe in there. For someone to sponsor my latest bill. Okay. Holy Toledo, why, you're Senator Bob Dole. I'm Stephen Q. Urkel, and I need a sponsor.
Mr. Urkel, how did you get in here?
Well, I snuck in. But really, what I want to talk to you about is I was hoping you would read the first 100 pages of my bill. Or perhaps I can recite the first 100 pages to you. Let's see here. I, Steven Q. Urkel, hereby submit to Congress a bill pertaining to clean air that will have a positive effect on all living organisms on this earth. And therefore, I submit for your sponsorship the Urkel Air Bill.
If I sponsor your bill, will you get out of here?
Oh, yes.
Seriously, though, if your bill passes, it'd be better for all Americans. But you must have a House sponsor because a bill must pass both the House and the Senate to become law.
Oh, Bob, I knew that. I'm not just another pretty face.
I could tell that.
Well, I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't. I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't.
Congressman Fields, I just want to thank you for sponsoring my bill. And I especially want to thank you for just seeing me.
Well, thank you, Mr. Urkel. But you see, I'm new on the Hill, and I just didn't know any better.
Wow.
Mr. Urkel, can I have a word with you?
Uh-huh. You're a lobbyist.
How do you know?
Because we're in the lobby, baby.
Mr. Urkel, I think I can convince the senator from Texas to support your bill. If you could agree to a few simple amendments...
Mr. Urkel, have you heard about this?
Holy moly, you're Tom Foley, the Speaker of the House. You're exactly the man I was looking for.
Are you sure?
Why, yes. You see, I have this bill, and it's in both houses, but I don't know what happens next.
Well, here's how it works. Over there is the United States Senate, made up of 100 senators, two from each state. And over there is the United States House of Representatives, where we have 435 representatives representing all the American people.
Oh.
And for your bill to become law, a majority, at least half plus one, of each one of those two bodies has to approve it. Now, before we vote on it in the House of Representatives, we sent your bill to a smaller group of representatives called the Committee on Natural Resources. They're trying to decide whether they can make your bill just a little bit better than it is now for all the people of the country. And I've just been told that the Natural Resources Committee has reported your bill, the Urkel Air Bill, and recommended that the full House of Representatives vote for it.
I am in support of this legislation on behalf of...
Chairman, I do not support the bill, and I will not support the bill under any...
I think we could make this a pretty good bill. I really congratulate you.
No way! This is probably the worst piece of legislation.
I warmly support this and hope that it will pass.
I thoroughly urge my colleagues' support for passage.
The Urkel Air Bill was reported by the Natural Resources Committee. The vote in the House was 231 for, 204 against. The Urkel Air Bill has now been passed by the House of Representatives.
Okay, my bill passed the House, but it's a little different than the one that passed in the Senate. In other words, my bill's now two bills, and these guys are gonna work out the differences. I'm not allowed inside. But that's no problem for the Urkman. Oh. Oh. Whoa. Mm-hmm.
Yes?
Okay. Give it to me straight. I can take it.
It's been approved here by the conference committee, but they've made some changes. And now I have to take it to the House and the Senate for another vote.
What in Sam Hill's going on this hill? We just went through that. Yoo-hoo-dee-hoo, Senator Dole, it's your old pal Steve.
Well, congratulations, Steve. I understand your bill has cleared the conference committee.
That's right. But thanks to you, I have to wait for another vote.
No, you have to understand. Your bill passes the House, then it passes the Senate, but it's a little different in each case, so it goes to a conference committee, and they clear up the differences. Then it has to clear each House again. But I've just been told your bill's in great shape.
Very interesting. Listen, by any chance, do you yodel? Yodel-a-hee-hoo!
No, but my dog barks, and when I was in the 10th Mountain Division years ago, I did yodel a little bit.
Oh, really?
Yeah, not as good as you can.
The question is on final passage of the bill. Committees in favor will say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, no.
No.
Any of the chair, the ayes have it.
Hello? This is Steven Q. Urkel calling. Is Bill there? Well, did you tell him it was the Urkman calling? Well, there's no need to get all huffy about it. Well, listen, he's got my bill, and he's had it for the last 6 days. If he doesn't sign it within the next four, it'll automatically become a law. Okay, I'll hold. I'll be here till Thursday. Get some sleep.